Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwe at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello, this is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwe of Living Streams International, bringing you matters of faith with Graphic Online. I'd like to capture my thoughts this morning with the words, love interference. Love interference. I hear whether sometimes your love for somebody might begin to interfere with the purposes of God for that particular person. Oh, wow. Yes, it is. Now, in the book of Numbers, if you remember, now here is Moses and Aaron and Miriam in Numbers chapter 12. And see what happens. Now, Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. Now, there was a little bit of a dispute, and the dispute was about Moses and his wife or whatever it was, because he had married an Ethiopian woman. And Miriam and Aaron then gets up to Moses, and then they tell Moses that, are you the only person who is a prophet? We are also prophets. We also hear from God. And it was a very, very bad patch. And listen, I mean, it was real bad. It was a hot argument. And let me say this without being chauvinistic. That issue started from Miriam. Listen, I mean, Moses had married another woman. And for me, this is my perspective. Miriam was saying, listen, I was the first lady. You were not around when I had to be with Moses at the Nile, you know, and where they had to take him. I had to make a bold approach to the princess. I had to make a bold approach to Pharaoh's daughter and tell Pharaoh's daughter that I know somebody. That particular moment of risk, you were not there. You were not there when we went into Egypt to try and sort everybody out. You were not there. When we were going through all those periods, you were not there, Miriam. And you're not there, whoever this woman was, this Ethiopian woman was. But then Miriam transferred, and Miriam spoke to Aaron and told Aaron, we are also prophets to her. Aaron said, yeah, we are also prophets, because I see Aaron as a very, very pacifist. Yet he's very, very passive in issues. And that's my take on Aaron. Very lame, and sometimes he can't stand up for the wrong. So Aaron goes ahead with Miriam, and then they approach Moses. You are not the only prophet. God also speaks to us. Blah, 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 blah. And it was a very hot contest. I mean, and the Bible said, I mean, God came to town. And then God said, listen, the man Moses, the one you're quarreling with, is the meekest man on the face of the earth. Oh, God, please, give a testimony like that about me. I'm trying. But here's the funny thing. God then says to Miriam and Aaron that, You are not afraid. Now here's the thing. God brings them to the place, and then he speaks. When he finishes speaking, Aaron was clear, Miriam was leprous. Miriam was instantly leprous, but Aaron was clear. That is why I said this thing started from Miriam. She was the cause of it. And God then decided to deal with the root cause, just like he does every time he comes to town. So if he meets a woman at the well who is talking about religion and race, and he says, my friend, your problem is love. That's what the problem is. You know, if Nicodemus comes asking all sort of questions in John 3, you say, my friend, you don't understand being born again. This is what it means. So God zeroed in on the problem, and Miriam got leprous, and Aaron walked away scot-free. And here is the thing. Moses then comes to town and saying to God, please, you don't have to touch me. Please leave her alone. And all those things. And then God said to Moses, excuse me, my friend, I am a father dealing with my daughter. It has got nothing to do with you. You don't love Miriam more than I do. I need to deal with something that will break her pride. I need to set her straight. I need to make sure that she doesn't get into this particular activity anymore. I need to deal with the thing once and for all. It is an issue between God and Miriam, and Moses, you got no part in it. Back off. Now here's the problem, and this is the challenge. Are you aware that sometimes our love for people might sometimes interfere with divine processes for their lives. Maybe God is taking some people through corrective measures. Maybe God is taking some people through some valleys. Maybe God is taking some people through some periods in their life where He's going to teach them a particular principle. And then all of a sudden, we then become interferences for that particular process in their lives. Because we want to stand in, want to stop it, we want to... No. Sometimes we need to be discerning enough to know that this one is a dealing of God. Oh, I've had countless measures, countless encounters like that, where there was something God was dealing with somebody, but my love for that person would want me to stand in the gap and say, God, you can't do that. Then He said, leave me alone. Back off. I want to teach the person a principle. May our love for people never interfere with the processes of God for their lives. See you later.